President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. speaking at Independence Day rights at the Camino Grandstand. Let's listen in.
Ideals for our free and independent country, popular, representative, and responsible. We have evolved into a healthy and vibrant republic with a stable government, supported by growing institutions and mechanisms, all of whose mandate and authority ultimately emanate from and are owed to the Filipino people. Then as now, it remains an unassailable, self-evident principle that sovereignty resides in our people. Ours is a government peopled by men and women of laws. We have a legal framework firmly in place that can enforce public order and bring justice, which operates within a judiciary designed as an independent and impartial tribunal. But in spite of these evolutionary developments, which are the hallmark of a free, independent, and democratic state, we still have a long, daunting journey ahead to fulfill the dreams of our forefathers. It is said that there are manifold unfreedoms prevailing in society that stand in the way of human development. These are the corrosive political and social conditions that make the nation not as free as we would like to profess and to believe, such as poverty, inadequate economic opportunities, disabling rather than enabling living conditions, inequality and apathy. Inequality and apathy. Our independence was not the end, but merely the principal means to achieve full development of the Filipino. Our success and the pursuit of happiness are not just the ultimate goals of our independence. These are to be seen as the expanded notions of human freedom. We subscribe to this, for after all, it is the blessing of independence and democracy that we have avowed to secure for ourselves and for our posterity. 125 years on, we will view our nation's development as freedom with more focus and determination. We will strive to remove the unfreedoms. We will aim to feed the hungry, free the bound, and banish poverty. These are primordial, moral, and existential imperatives that are laid upon your government. Through wise policies, we will foster a highly conducive and enabling environment in which the exercise of true human compassion shall allow for the full development of the Filipino. We have laid down the Philippine Development Plan for the next 6 years. We will implement such with vigor and with consistency. In this administration, the government will be responsible. I have said it before, I shall say it once more. I will be with you on that long and uphill road to achieve our dream of freedom. Freedom from hunger, freedom from neglect, freedom from fear. But as integral actors in our democracy, we are all involved in this collective pursuit of real freedoms. That duty rests with all of us. So once again, I appeal for unity and solidarity in our efforts to perfect our hard-fought freedom and achieve genuine national progress. Heeding this call will indispensably require patriotism and a strong sense of community, diligence, industry, and responsibility from all our citizens. As President, I call to mind and once again declare the exhortation of the leader of the Philippine Revolutionary Government and the first President of the Republic of the Philippines, General Emilio Aguinaldo. And he said, "We cannot free ourselves unless we move forward united in a single desire." This is our single desire, to be genuinely free by achieving full development as a single, united, and indivisible Filipino nation. With this desire, let us renew the pledge made by our forefathers, imbued with firm confidence in divine providence, Let us bind ourselves to support our free and independent republic, if need be with our lives, with our fortunes, and with our most sacred blessing, our honor. We owe this to our national heroes who had won for us this freedom that we now enjoy. We owe this to the next generations of Filipinos to whom we swear to bequeath a stronger and genuinely free republic. Mabuhay ang malayang sambayan ng Pilipino. Mabuhay ang Pilipinas magpakailanman. Maraming salamat po at magandang umaga sa inyong lahat.
And that was the president talking about that long, daunting journey ahead to fulfill the dreams of our forefathers. He did recognize the many unfreedoms prevailing in society today as standing in the way of human development. He says 125 years on, we have to view the nation's development as a freedom with more focus and determination. We need to remove unfreedoms, feed the hungry, free the bound, and banish poverty, which is the primordial moral and existential imperatives laid upon government. He did say government will be responsible. He said it before. He's saying it again. He will be with the Filipino people in the long and uphill road to achieve the dreams of freedom from hunger, freedom from neglect, and freedom for fear. He did call to mind towards the end of his speech and exhorted the leader. Some lines from the leader of the Philippine Revolutionary Government and the first president of the Republic of the Philippines, Emilio Aguinaldo, General Emilio Aguinaldo, who said, "We cannot free ourselves unless we move forward united in a single desire." So this is our single desire, he says, that we are genuinely free by achieving the full development as a single, united, and indivisible Philippine nation.